not so much a yarn about value-adding wool as it is about the byproduct that's turning out to be nearly as valuable as the golden fleece itself. Wool grease is the natural oil that helps make wool water repellent, protecting sheep from the harsh effects of weather. Secreted by the sheep's skin, it continuously collects on the wool so that by the time the fleece is harvested, it makes up between 15 and 25% of the total weight of freshly cut wool. The ancient Greeks were among the first to seize the potential of this natural emollient as a preservative, protectant and lubricant for use in things such as ointments and on everything from clothing and shelters to spears. While this rather crude use of wool grease continued from about 700 BC onwards, it was the late 19th century before a process was developed to refine what we now know as lanolin. The Adelaide-based G.H. Michel Company is the largest exporter and processor of Australian wool. Almost 500,000 bales, or 15% of the wool clip, is processed at this plant. Michel's produces about 250 drums of lanolin each week. Almost all of it is exported, destined to be further processed into a surprising range of highly value-added applications, from cosmetics and pharmaceuticals to soaps, polishes, paints, putties, and protectant coatings.
I use it in my workshop. I use it on a multitude of things. Sticky windows, door keys that won't work, people's petrol caps that won't come undone, leather, shoes that are not weatherproof. Spray it on your shoes, they become weatherproof within minutes, basically.
We first started using the product, obviously, in lift chains and our container lifting equipment, and with great success. We found it, the wear component dropped, and obviously the lubricant kicked in, and it helped us greatly. So,
have you been able to sort of quantify what sorts of savings and what sort of improved performance?
Well, basically, we've been able to extend our chain maintenance from a weekly lubrication to a monthly lubrication, and you know, we've been doing that now for the past 12 months with great success. As you can see, with the so many moving parts in these chains, you really need a lubricant that will penetrate in and provide the links and the pins as much lubrication as possible, because we're looking at thousands of dollars worth of chain. So any cost savings due to that is a big bonus to the company.
More corrosive environment than a fertiliser plant, especially with our location straight beside the Brisbane River on one side, and on the other side we have a creek off the river, Doughboy Creek. So we're pretty well surrounded by water, seawater, and quite close to the mouth of the river also.
He was impressed with the preliminary results of a trial where one coat of lanolin replaced a three-coat treatment that normally took 10 days to complete.
As you can appreciate, $200,000 a day in gas into our reformer every hour and minute of the day is crucial to Incitec. So, yeah, if we can look at reducing our turnaround time on the jobs, again, that's certainly an advantage to Incitec, and that cost saving in itself could be quantified to some serious sort of money.
But more importantly, what appealed to the company was that the product is safer to handle than many of the alternatives.
The fitters and tradesmen working in the conditions all day, they've found it well to use. You know, you can apply it in the morning, it's still there in the afternoon. And at the end of the day, I'd rather see a squirt of lanolin going in their toolbox than in the past, all the nasties going up into the air and into their lungs and basically all over our floor and eventually into the drain. So my technicians are telling me that they haven't found a better product, they haven't used a better product.
Heavy machinery distributor Hastings Deering was after a more efficient and environmentally friendly protective coating for the machinery it dispatches throughout the Pacific. This huge grader, for instance, is on its way to the Lihir gold mine in Papua New Guinea as deck cargo. In central Queensland, the heavy-duty liquid lanolin is being used by contractors working on raising the height of the Awonga Dam by 10 metres. A $106 million project will triple the dam capacity from 250,000 to 800,000 megalitres to meet the current and projected water needs of the city of Gladstone and its expanding industrial base.
We're working in a dam and we're very conscious of making sure what we leave behind, it's in the same condition that we arrive. We look for products that leave a positive impact, and this product certainly helps us achieve that goal. We're currently using it on our formwork. It is used to seal the formwork and to help us with our stripping of the concrete works.
It's a lot better on the ply. It seems to make it last a hell of a lot longer because that is 9 pours old, that ply, and like I said, it's nearly as good as when we first started. Mm. So for us, you'll get more uses out of the ply, yeah. and it doesn't get waterlogged because we're using a high volume of water to green cut.
Yes.
And then the concrete gets cured for 7 days with water on it. This is constantly covered in water, and like I said, it doesn't swell. So we put it on the back of the shutter as well to stop the timbers swelling as well.
Yeah.
And it seems to work out just fine. So in that respect, it's best stuff we've used so far.
Downstream at Gladstone's Botanic Gardens, they're pretty careful about what ends up in their waterways too. Over the past 13 years, it's become a popular recreation reserve and a refuge for the area's wildlife.
The gardens were well planned, and I think that's probably the big success with them. There's clear wheelchair access right through the gardens, which make it very accessible to everyone.
You've got a lot of timber work here, observation towers, kiosks, and of course all this decking and bridges and so forth. What was the challenge as to how would you preserve that?
Well, that's the thing. There's a lot of substantial timber. Some of these timbers you can see here are 12x3 spotted gum that you simply wouldn't see anymore, even if you could afford it. It's not really available, that sort of timber. So it's to the stage there now where the timber's about 12 to 13 years old, and it's fairly crucial that we start preserving it. And obviously in an environment like this, anything that's even slightly toxic to the waterways or the plants could be quite a problem. So we were quite impressed with the landowner when it came along to see it used.
Certainly we've got a lot of timber work scattered throughout the city, a lot of timber boardwalks and a lot of construction going on. So if it proves successful, we'd certainly like to try it further.
We like to support Australian-owned companies, and like I said, it all comes back to performance and results. And if you've got a product that's Australian-made, and it's providing results, well, that's fine by us to use.